MLB Network is your exclusive home for postseason baseball. It's the second game of the National League Championship Series between the Chicago Cubs and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian welcoming you to our exclusive postseason coverage on MLB Network. I'm joined by Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Danny, an important ballgame coming up here in Game 2.
Well, in a seven-game series, winning Game 1 on the road is great, but it doesn't mean all that much if you can't back it up and win Game 2. A win here really puts them in a commanding position, but if they split these first two games, it basically becomes a best-of-a-five-game series starting all over again from scratch.
All right, the stage is set. The starters get their final tosses in out in the bullpen, and we've got a good one in store for you, folks. Play-by-play is coming up next. Tony Gonsolin is on the mound for Game 2. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
If you want to pick up a win as a starting pitcher, you have to go five innings to get the win, and that's just what he did the last one. I'm sure he'd like to be out there for a little bit longer in this one.
Coming to the plate now, Chris Bryant, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Pitch hit in the air toward the gap in right center. On the move is Betts. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
Batting second, the first baseman, number 44, Anthony Rizzo.
Into the box now, Anthony Rizzo, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. One out, nobody on. Sharp ground ball toward the hole. Reined in. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out. So bases are empty here with two gone. And into bat next, the versatile weapon, Javier Baez. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Ed Drummond.
Yeah, Matty, hey, you know what, Bureau? This Ed Drummond, he's a good umpire. Fair umpire, good ball and strike umpire. Pretty much straight down the road.
That's all you look for, Dan. Just be consistent. I don't care if you're given 2 to 3 inches off the outside corner, but you can't do it on the inside corner. If you're going to stick to one thing and stay consistent with it, no player will have a gripe with you.
Another full count pitch home. Skied into straightaway right. On the move is Betts. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. So a rather pedestrian start to the top half of the first. And now the Dodgers get a crack at it. No score. Kyle Hendricks will be on the bump for Game 2 of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, Kyle Hendricks is not one of these overpowering guys. He's a little bit, he reminds me of Greg Maddux. He's 88 to 91 with really good sink, great straight changeup, and has the slurve. Not a true curveball, not a true slider. The key to Kyle Hendricks, inducing early contact. The more pitches that hitters see, the better chance they have to hit on him. If Kyle Hendricks is on, you'll know early he'll be getting a lot of quick outs.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. A bouncer to the left side. And that's out number one.
Batting second, the shortstop, Corey Seager.
So the base is empty here with one away. And up next, the former All-Star shortstop, Corey Seager.
Bases are empty, one man out.
Oh, and he hammers it to deep right field. Gone! A solo home run for Corey Seager.
His first homer so far in the series,
and they've taken a one-run lead.
That's how the manager drew it up right there. Hold the visiting team scoreless and then grab a huge home run in the first.
Standing in now, Max Muncy. 1-2 as the changeup had him out in front there. Into the corner and slicing foul. The 1-2. Got him swinging in the dirt. He makes the throw to first. Two down. And next will be the Dodgers cleanup hitter, Cody Bellinger, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Now the 2-1. Here's a chopper to first. Onto the bag with it is Rizzo, and the inning is over. Some more of the colorful characters here at the ballpark tonight. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Second inning set to go, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitting Kyle Schwarber. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. The next 3-2. High in the air, carrying well out to deep center. Going back is the center fielder. And off the batter's eye for a home run. An impressive shot to dead center field. A solo home run for Kyle Schwarber. His first homer here in the series. And the Cubs are back to even now at one run apiece.
One of the best qualities of this pitcher is keeping the ball in the ballpark. He's not an easy guy to get the ball up in the air again, so he's going to have to regroup a little bit here. He's not used to giving up home runs.
A strike to Contreras, and it's 1-1. Hard hit ball to second. On to first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out.
Batting fifth, the right fielder, Nathan Hayward.
So one away here with the bases empty, and that'll bring up the multi-gold glover, Jason Hayward.
fouls this one off. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down.
This inning didn't get started the way he'd hoped with that home run, but I've got to give him credit for flushing it and coming back here to get strikeouts on the last two guys. He's acting like it didn't even happen before.
Stepping in now, Cameron Maben. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. Fouled off. Splitter here, but he had a bit too much on it as this bounces up to the plate.
That pitch was way down on 2-2, but give the hitter some credit there. Sometimes with two strikes, you're more off to expand the strike zone, but he didn't, and help.
Swing, high drive, left field and deep. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. But the Cubs draw even thanks to this solo home run. We'll go to the bottom of the second, all even now at 1-1. Bottom of the inning now, and digging in is the veteran DH, A.J. Pollock. The 2-1 home. And this ball hits the first base bag. And a reach to his backhand, but he can't come up with it, and the leadoff man's aboard. And it's a good start to the inning for the Dodgers on the leadoff double. Wow, this is a perfect example of a wily veteran doing what needs to be done to deliver for his team.
Yeah, and just watch this swing. Instead of trying to do too much with it and pull it, he stays inside the ball and is able to smack it to the opposite field for a double.
In now, Jock Peterson. In for strike two. Goes after the sinker there as this is fouled away. Pollock stands at second with no outs. And another foul ball. The 1-2. Line toward the alley in left center, and that's going to get down out there, and that'll score the run from second as they jump in front now 2-1.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Roy. You get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%, not trying to do too much, able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
Into the box now, Justin Turner. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. His matchup numbers with Hendricks. He's 4-for-11. Two of those hits were for home runs. Hit out towards second. Taken in by Kipnis. One there. On to Rizzo at first, and they get them both.
It's hard to do anything with a pitch like that that's below the zone. And if you do do anything with it, most of the time, this will be the result. A double play on a good pitch down in the zone.
So base is empty now after the double play. And next to hit is the catcher, Will Smith. A 1-1.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
Oh. 2-2 to the Dodgers catcher. Two out, nobody on. Skied into straightaway right. Hayward is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. It's a run on two hits here for L.A. We played two full. It's the Dodgers 2 and the Cubs 1. And that'll bring in the Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. Happ with a 2-1 count now. The 2-1. And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play, so the count goes to 2-2 now. Now here's the pitch. Again, he sends it out of play. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
It's been a great job so far by the eight-hole hitter. If he finds a way to get on base, this could spell for a huge inning.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
Yeah, and as a starter, the last thing you want to do is let a team answer when your guys just scored a run for you. So he's thinking ground ball right here to try to get a double play and end this threat.
Now at the plate, Jason Kipnis. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. A 2-1 score here as we play inning number three. Fouled away. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2.
He was looking for a swing and a missed breaker right there, but left that one in the zone that got fouled off.
Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
Blake now, Chris Bryant, and a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away. And with two away, let's check in with our up-to-the-minute playoff bracket. And you can see our series at 1-0 as things are starting to heat up here as we get later into October. So two are gone now in the Cubs' half of the third. And into bat next, the left-handed hitting first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Has a look, now the pitch. He turns on it and sends it deep down the line and right. A ball that's carrying. Almost into the short porch, but it's off the wall. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
Man, they already hit one home run, and I thought they had a second one right there. Not quite enough behind it, though, as it banged off the wall for a double. He's giving up a fair amount of solid contact right now.
Ball at the plate, Javier Baez. Two balls and a strike to Javi Baez. Two and one, here it is.
Nope, that's down.
This is where you cash your checks right here. 3-1, you're one of the best hitters in the game. You live for situations like this.
Two out here and a runner at second. This is skied into short left center. Peterson has a read on it. And the inning is over. The Cubs get a run courtesy of Anthony Rizzo. Bottom of the third coming up, and we're deadlocked now at two apiece. Bottom of the third now, and set to go is the second baseman, Gavin Lux. Hit hard up the middle. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard.
Hey, some guys can handle the postseason lights, and this is obviously one of them. Another base hit leading off for the boys. This guy's had a monster postseason so far.
Standing in now, Mookie Betts. Hit hard to third. Bryant is up with it to second for one. On the first, and it's another double play. Already two of them here in the first three innings so far.
That's a great example there of why the sinker is such an effective pitch. The hitter's eyes see it higher in the zone than it ends up, and that makes it real tough to square up.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And striding to the plate will be Corey Seager.
That was a pretty good pitch, too, man. That last AB, but he went deep. That was a fastball that was in and off the plate. So that tells me this guy likes the ball on that inner half of the plate or even inside off the plate. If I'm on the mound right now, I'm keeping the ball away from this guy.
Back up the middle and in for a base hit. So a nice job there by the two-hole hitter to extend the inning for the middle of the order.
Hey, D-Roll, that's just what you want to do. Keep the pressure on. He's given up a couple of runs early already in this game, and now he gives up the two-out single.
Yeah, no chance right there. You want to make this guy work. You want to try and get into their pen as quick as possible. And if two-out knocks are the answer, then so be it.
Stepping in now, Max Muncy. The 2-2. A runner on first with two away. Hit to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. One left for LA. We're through three, tied two apiece. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Cubs to discuss his thoughts on his lineup so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already. And he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Trying to pick things up where we left off, Kyle Schwarber, as we begin the top of the fourth.
And hey, it was a breaking ball to boot. This guy's a pretty good off-speed hitter. You could tell by that last at-bat, he wasn't fooled at all. He sat back, waited, got the breaking ball, and didn't miss it.
A full count now to Kyle Schwarber. Off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Man, when the game is tied, the last thing you can afford to do is walk the leadoff hitter. Got to focus on getting that ground ball now.
Ready now, Wilson Contreras. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
2-2 to the Cubs catcher. Nobody out, runner on first. A ground ball to third, and they could get two. To second for one, over to Muncy, and they double him up.
Nice job on the mound to bounce back from the leadoff walk. Those are usually pretty costly, but that won't be the case this time after the two ball.
So that'll bring up Jason Hayward, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. Two runs on two hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. And he struck him out. Second time tonight now that he's been set down on strikes. Cubs are down quietly. He'll go to the bottom of the fourth, all even at two apiece. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already. And he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Cody Bellinger. The 1-1. Lays off 2-2 now. High in the air out to center field. Center fielder on the run. He's there and records the first out. One gun now in the Dodger fourth. And up next, the center fielder, A.J. Pollock. Two runs, five hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. So bases are empty here with two gone, and in steps a former World Series hero, the outfielder Jock Peterson. Now the 2-1 pitch. Hit out towards second. Kipnis has it. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. Through four, we're deadlocked at two apiece. So digging in now, Cameron Maben. He'll start off the fifth in this one. The 1-1 home. Misses for the second ball.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch, but if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter. Ian Happ, the number 8 hitter here, waits on deck. The 3-1. And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning.
And this is exactly what you want to do when you're trying to put a start away. Make him work his tail off, throw a lot of pitches, and get on base any way that you can. A big inning at this point of the game, and he's probably gone.
Digging in the switch hitter, Ian Happ. He worked a walk and came around to score in his first trip in this game. The 1-2. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. And that'll get down out there for extra bases.
Boy, there's a long drive bullet off the wall right there. But the outfielder does a really good job, Nero, of getting that one quickly and getting it back in to keep him at first for a long single.
Yeah, and also nice job by the base runner not there. Not putting his head down, being over-aggressive and getting thrown out at second base. He saw the play happening in front of him and put the brakes on and got back for a base hit.
Yeah, Nero, I think he would have been toast if he tried to stretch that one into a double.
Into the box, Jason Kipnis. And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. Back goes Betts to the track. A leap, but he can't bring it back into the park. It's a home run. So it's a three-run shot to straightaway right field. His first homer so far in the series. And just like that, it's now a 5-2 ball game.
Well, with no outs, you can afford to give up a single, but you can't afford to give up a three-run homer. He just caught too much of the plate. Now he's back to the drawing board. No outs, and the inning is already an ugly one.
Here comes the Dodger manager making his way toward the mound. And he's looking to the bullpen here, so it would appear that's all for his starter tonight. So he'll leave after working just four innings, and this was not the kind of start he was looking for, I'm quite sure. Dustin May, a right-hander standing 6'6", will take over pitching duties here.
Number 85, Dustin May.
Chris Bryant will be the first one to greet him as he'll start fresh here with the bases empty following the home run. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Right side, hit hard. And the throw to first is in time, one gone. Final line there for the Dodgers starting pitcher. Clearly not the postseason outing he had envisioned.
Yeah, nothing seemed in sync for him out there in this one, Matt. He just couldn't get the ball where he wanted to, and the opponents really took advantage of that. That's a brutal feeling sitting in the dugout. Know that you disappointed your team and you went out there and laid an egg.
And he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike. Some action in the Dodger bullpen now as it appears they have both a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. Looked like he got fooled on the speed there, 2-2.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
So it was a strikeout looking there. Anthony Rizzo goes down for out number two in the top half. So bases are empty here with two gone. And with it comes Javi Baez to the plate. Three runs already home here. Hit in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. The 1-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. But the Cubs do get three on the three-run home run. Bottom of the fifth coming up. It's now 5-2 Chicago. Leading off the inning, Justin Turner, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. Hard hit ball to second. And a good throw gets him one gone. Next up for Los Angeles, Will Smith. He flew out in his last at bat. Good idea with the change, but it's 2-1. Swing and a miss, strike two.
Hey boys, you talking about getting your ace swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power letting it eat.
Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. And he'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning.
Now batting.
Stepping in, Gavin Lux. He reached on a single in his first try. Bases are empty here with two men out. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. Again, another foul ball. Again, a 1-2. Right side. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single. So that'll bring in Mookie Betts. We're in the fifth inning here. 5-2 is our score. And it's fouled away. The 1-2.
Oh, that's off the plate.
Man, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
In the dirt, but swung on and missed. And the throw to first ends the inning. So no runs on a hit here, no errors, one man left on. Five innings complete. The Cubbies are in front, 5-2. So here's the cleanup hitter, Kyle Schwarber. He'll look to get things going here in the Cubs' half of the sixth. Now the 1-1 pitch. Is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
You got to be paying attention as an offense in a hitter's meeting in this situation. When you got a guy on the mound that you know the bottom can drop out of any pitch he throws, you have to elevate your sights.
Squared that one up just a little late. Here's another 1-2. Oh, right back to him on the mound. And he'll flip on to first to record the out. Next to hit will be Wilson Contreras. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. 5-2 is our score here in inning number six. This is line to left. And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. And he'll pull into second with one away. Not every day that you see a ball come off the bat like that one did. And looking at it again on show track, we see it a lot faster than it came in. 113 miles an hour. Couldn't have hit that one much better than that. So now to the plate, Jason Hayward. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact.
couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Lifted in the air out to left field. On the move is Peterson. He gets there to put it away, but the runner tags and breaks for third. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning. Stepping up to the plate, Cameron Maybin. And he fouls this one off. The 1-2. Swing and a ball hit out toward right center. Betts has a read on it. And the inning is over. Cubs strand one. They're still out in front, 5-2. Corey Seager will stand in again, but first we'll flash you back to the very first inning of the ballgame. And here you go, a solo home run that had him off and running early on. Two swinging. Two balls and two strikes to Corey Seager. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. The 2-2. Sent on the ground out to second. Kipnis is there, and there's one away. Next up is Max Muncy. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hard liner, but picked up on a hop. On to first, and there were two down.
The center fielder,
Cody Bellinger at the plate now. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one.
Bellinger.
Two out, nobody on. Good change of speeds, but he lays off 2-1.
Sitting in a good spot right here. Two ball, one strike count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
The 2-1 home.
Oh, that's low.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
The 3-1 pitch. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. Curveball locks him up. Strike three, and that's the third out. Dodgers down in order, and the deficit remains 5-2. Seventh inning ready to roll, and coming forward is the switch hitting outfielder, Ian Happ. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Now a ground ball to Seager at short. Scooped up. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. Jason Kipnis will stand in as he's accounted for one of the biggest at-bats of the game so far. A 3-run shot back in the fifth that's really energized his ball club. The 2-1 home. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. The last thing you want to do is to fall behind the count 3-2.
And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning.
Flat out locked him up with a changeup right there. Usually you're trying for a swing and miss when you throw that pitch in a two-strike count, but clearly he wasn't looking for it, so it's a backwards K for him.
To the plate now, Chris Bryant. Seared down the first baseline, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Now the pitch.
Good job to lay off that 1-2 breaking ball. Put himself right back in this at bat.
5-2 our score as we play inning number 7. Fouled off. Here now the 2-2. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Bryant around first, heading for second. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away.
As we take a look at the replay here, you can see that it was a hanging changeup. Nice job of staying back on it, and he's able to tattoo it for a double. And you know, if that pitch would have supplied more velocity, it might have been out of here. He hit it right on the screws.
Into the box now, Anthony Rizzo. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Popped him up. Lux calls for it. And that retires the side. Danger averted following the two-out double. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. Dan Winkler gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home 7.
43, Dan Winkler.
Last half of the 7th here, and that'll bring up A.J. Pollock. And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside, 3-2. Fouled away. The next 3-2. And it's fouled away. Once again, a 3-2. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
That strikeout was a real good example of a pitcher continuing to make a guy chase out of the zone. When you recognize a hitter is in protect mode, you don't have to come inside the strike zone. You can just expand further and further until he literally can't touch it.
In now, Jock Peterson. You can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number 2.
Just tied him up with that last pitch. Pretty evident by the swing. Sometimes guys get in that protect mode so much that they're swinging at everything that they see, and they end up offering at pitches that they can't possibly do anything with.
Standing in now, Justin Turner. Down the first baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
You know, you don't always have to straight challenge a guy on a 3-2 count. with the three-run lead, no one on base. This is the perfect.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. They trail 5-2. Ready to begin the eighth, and into bat next, the versatile weapon Javier Baez. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hot shot to third. Turner's got it. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. Kyle Schwarber will stand in here hoping to duplicate what he did back in the second inning. As we flash you back to take another look at his solo home run that helped get this offense rolling. A full count now to Kyle Schwarber. Rolled slowly down the third baseline. And he looks at a sinker for a called third strike, and now there are two gone.
The catcher, number 40.
Here's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. We're in the eighth inning now of a 5-2 ball game. Line towards center field. That gets down, and the inning will continue. The throw into second. The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. Three up, three down for the Cubs. And it remains 5-2. Greg Kimbrel is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 48, Greg Kimbrel.
At the plate now, Will Smith. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. The 2-2 one more time. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Stepping in now, Gavin Lux. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Got to find a way to scratch at least one across. You do not want to take on the monster closing the game down three.
The 3-1 pitch is taken for strike two.
Full count, 3-2.
He strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
So now to the plate, Mookie Betts. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. The 1-2 misses, ball two. The 2-2.
Full count, 3-2.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck.
I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
Kimbrel pauses on his way with the 3-2. Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. Betts is going to turn for second. And he will pull into second with a two-out double.
Hey, guys, he doubled up on that breaking ball. The batter obviously timed the first one. Second one, he was not going to let go. Good wood on that one, able to drive it for a base hit.
Into the box, Corey Seager. Line drive, base hit. Betts is on his way home. The relay. And it's in time. He's out at second as a good relay gets him. Only one in the inning here for the guys in blue. Game two heads to the ninth inning. The Cubs are on top, 5-3. Into the box now, Jason Hayward. Swing and a line drive. And Hayward's now 0-for-3 so far as he's retired again here for the first out.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
Here's Cameron Maben now. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Just off the end of the bat, it's a foul ball, and he'll stick around. 2-2 one more time.
You got a full count.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Popped him up. Muncy over to his right, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Now with the plate, Ian Happ. He was a ground out victim last time up. Down the third baseline, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. Now here's the pitch. And he struck him out. So a good pitch there, and now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at-bat if they want to get back in this thing. Nothing across here this half. Heart of the order, 3, 4, and 5 will get their shot in the bottom of the ninth. It's the Cubs 5 and the Dodgers 3. Andrew Chafin takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Chicago Cubs, number 47, Andrew Chafin.
Into the box now, Max Muncy. He's the one to start off the ninth inning with his guys in danger of going down 2-0 if they can't rally. To foul this one away. Chafin is among a dying breed, those lefty specialists whose roles are changing with the new rules around reliever usage. Now Muncy with a swing and a deep drive to right. And out of here, and I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. A solo shot down the line and right as they pull within one here. It's now a 5-4 game.
Friends, is a cardinal sin for any closer. You can't give up the long ball. Good thing for him, he still has the lead. We'll see now if he can rebound and actually keep it.
To the plate now, Cody Bellinger on the ground to the left side. Bryant's got it.
throw, not nearly in time as he reaches it first.
Hey, that's great hustle right there out of the box. Not everybody's getting it right out of the chute from step one, but I have to ask you, Dan, how frustrating executing a pitch and there's an infield knock.
It is, D-Lo, and you can read that right off the bat as a pitcher. You can read the angle. You know that ball is going to be hit on the ground, and you're thinking deep down inside, okay, there's a quick out, and it just wasn't meant to be.
Working for the punch out and the offering. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact.
Hey, this isn't going to be an easy save. These guys are making it work for this one.
He's set, and the payoff pitch. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Schwarber is there, one away. Into the box, Jock Peterson. He'll be looking for something he could drive into the gap and drive home that tying run from first. The 1-2.
Got to take advantage of that pitch right there. 0-2 breaker hanging over the heart of the plate. Not going to see too many of those today.
And he lays off the pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Runners on first with one down. A bouncer up the middle. There's one. Back to first. It's a double play. Right when he needed it, and this ball game is over.
Well, that's not exactly how you draw it up. He gave up a long ball to make it interesting, but it was the only run he gave up, and he hangs on to collect the save.
Tight ball game all throughout. Winds up a slim one-run victory in the end as we get you one final look at our line score. And there's no better time of year to come up big for your team than in the postseason. And that's exactly what this man did. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, no time like the postseason to come through and lift your team to victory. He was certainly a big factor here, and it was pretty cool to see.
This evening's game comes to an end, 5-4, the final tally. Chicago take a 2-0 lead here in the league championship series. Kyle Hendricks pitches well enough to get the W. Tony Gonsolin was only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. So that's a wrap for us in this one. Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, Matt Vasgersian, we all thank you for watching Major League Baseball on MLB Network. See you next time.
Here now is the final line score tonight. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. 5 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 3 men on base. For the Dodgers, 4 runs on 10 hits, no errors. They left 4 men on base. Time of the ballgame, 3 hours and 20 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance, a sellout, 56,000. The Dodgers thank you for attending tonight's game. And as you leave Dodger Stadium, we remind you to please drive home safely.